last Friday of rifle season. Got the whole day off. And the target buck showed up last night just across the power line from us. It's the first time he's ever been on that camera. I've had it there for well over a month. So he's, as of last night, he was still alive. As you guys can see, the deer are definitely on their feet this morning. They're over here across the power line right now. I can't shoot into there. It's so thick. Oh, we got a deer coming. Stay still for right now. There's a bunch of deer coming out. Yeah. I see at least two. Alright, I'm gonna slowly try to rotate you guys. freaking hard. Finally got one. I am going to stay in the tree. I'm not going to get down right away. She's down right there at like 50 yards. She didn't freaking move really. So I'm just going to stay put. I technically have two more tags. Like, there's a deer right there that I could shoot right now. How crazy would that be? I got a giant doe. Yeah, dude, like, huge. Like, neck rolls huge. Yeah, she ran like 10 yards and fell over. Yeah, I've seen a ton of deer this morning. Yeah, so I told you you'd be my second phone call. You're the second phone call. Yeah, I'm the only shot I heard all day. I've hunted really freaking hard this year, and I made a lot of freaking mistakes, and it felt really good to have everything to come together and be able to harvest a really nice sized doe. When I first saw her, she showed up over there next to the bulldozer, because I really wasn't paying attention over there. I was watching, there's three other doe that I was watching. And, she showed up, and I, at first, automatically just assumed it was a buck, because the body on her was so freaking big. That good old 30-06. Let that thing eat. Man, oh man. That was awesome. Like I said, I have been hunting like crazy this year. And, you know, everyone's been asking me, when are you gonna get something? When are you gonna get something? And I'll be the first to tell you, hunting is not all about getting something. It's just not. It's not the most important thing. It's, for me, it's the hunt. It's the hunt. It's not the kill, it's the hunt. Yeah, it feels great to finally get something, but I've loved every second of stressing out over whether or not I'm going to get at least a deer, let alone a buck.
Well, I just got down. Let's go over and see if we can find her. She was just behind the bulldozer there. Right there. And I'm pretty sure she's laying somewhere right there. She didn't make it out of there. Thank God for that bulldozer, or I probably wouldn't have been able to shoot. I was able to use that as like a backstop. There is a house up that way, and I try to be real careful with my shots. There she is. Right there. Oh my. Oh my, oh my. She's pretty freaking big. just gotta find the tag. 5C. That's me. Alright. I have to notch the tag now, which is kinda new. Alright. I'm gonna call that good. So what I do when I tag my deer, I put the license back inside of my license holder, because it's supposed to be pinned to the deer's ear, and then that way I can use my license holder to hold my tag on. Ooh, bloody. There you have it, guys. Big doe. So happy to be able to harvest this today. Man, she stinks. Why does she smell? But I gotta get her gutted, start the drag. I have a little bit of a drag ahead of me here, but that's part of it. Get to remember how out of shape I am. Yeah, actually, I don't remember the last time I drug a deer out by myself. It's been a number of years. This one's definitely going to put me to the test. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Especially because I'm going to have everything with me. But let's get her gutted up and hopefully she gets a little bit lighter.